Hi, and welcome to the posing sessions. In the next couple of sessions, we are going to pose Jack. So, let's get started. This is the pose that I like, at least something in that manner. Okay, so the first thing that we'll want to do is return Jack to this neutral pose. To be facing the camera directly. And the first thing that we're going to do is pose the arms. Now I'm just looking at this topology here, and I'm, you know, to tell you the truth, not 100% happy with it. I think it's going to give us a little bit of a problem when we start bending hands. So I want to add one more edge loop here, just to give us a better situation when we start bending the shoulders. So we have to kind of change the topology a little bit, and it's you know, just a matter of seeing how these polygons would go best to facilitate the bending that we need. Now we have this three-point polygon here. I don't want, actually. And if we must have it, or we can keep it hidden there, it's not going to be seen. So if there's any pinching caused by this three-point polygon, it's not going to be visible. And now just to rearrange a little bit our topology according to this new situation. Okay, yep, that's what I wanted to get. Now it's just a matter of welding up a few points. Okay. Now, just to get rid of those two-point polygons that were created when we were welding our four-point polygons, and just to keep things neater and simpler, I'm going to hide everything except the area on which we want to work on. And start bending. So I'm just going to name this, you know, give this left arm a different surface so we can always have it handy for selection. We can always select it just by, you know, picking that surface. So it's just something to help us, you know, with our workflow. And now after we bend, we just want to relax the geometry a little bit. And the shoulder is kind of popping too much in the back. Just push it a little bit in front. So now you can again see the advantages of having a low poly mesh to work with. it's a lot easier to pose it than it would be if we had a higher resolution mesh. And like this, it's a lot easier. And now we just have to add a little bit more edge loops in the elbow area. And that is going to allow us to bend this and maintain the structure, you know, of the rest of the arm. And once you're relatively happy with the pose of the left arm, we're going to do the same thing with the right arm. That includes renaming it for, you know, just easier selection. And then just kind of positioning it. And already it's a little bit more easier because we have the left arm as reference, you know, where we want to be approximately. So I want him to be able to grab that arm, you know, in this pose that we've chosen. So I'm kind of taking that into consideration. And this is also a place where, you know, your elbow position will be tested. You know, if you chose the right distance from the shoulder to the elbow. That is something you can always easily adjust, you know, extend a certain part. And this is what we have so far. And I like that position. Now I just want to go in and again work on this, on those polygons here, which are now kind of bending a little bit awkward. So hiding the rest of our model, so it's easier to get into those areas that we want to fix without being bothered by the rest of the geometry. Just a few minor adjustments. And yeah. Yeah, that's looking pretty good. It still lacks a little bit more, a little bit more work, you know. Want to add a, you know, a bit subtleness to the pose, and you know, I want Jack to kind of be almost like relaxed, confident. You know, he's the king of the graveyard, and one of the ways I want to achieve this is by tilting his shoulders. You know, to put him kind of like a more relaxed pose. And also give him a little bit of arching back position. You know, he's confident. He has his arms crossed, you know. And he knows he's the king of the Halloween. So I'm just kind of looking at the model from you know, a distance, also to see how the pose feels. You don't want to be focusing, you know, just on one area, disregarding, you know, how it looks in accordance to the whole body. The pose has to work, you know, from the head to the toes. It has to make sense. So that's just something to keep in your mind. And now, working on this elbow area, it definitely requires a bit more geometry there, because we want to also be able to add some clothes creasing. that happens. And that's what you see me doing here right now. We want to, you know, just add that bit of touch, you know, extra touch for giving it a bit more natural look. You don't want it to, you know, have this feel of a tube. So it should have some creasing there. And, you know, that goes for the whole arm. Again, just trying to break that, those perfectly straight lines, which we never see, you know, basically in nature, especially when, you know, talking about fabric. So you can maybe make some of these creases a bit bigger, you know, just so they are more noticeable, especially when you go into sap patching. And of course, you should always be mindful of, you know, the real estate a certain part you're working on is going to take in the final render. So sometimes you might have to give a little bit even of a bigger accent to some areas, to some things, just so that they show up, you know, in your render. But of course, you don't want to go too far with it. The one thing I want to do is kind of put this at the same surface as the rest of the jacket, so we have a better idea. You know, it looks a bit more natural to the eye. So we can see where we're at. Now we have to do the same thing with this right elbow as well. Some of these polygons are going to twist, especially in these elbow areas, you know, joint areas where you really have to bend the topology. They're going to twist, so we have to, you know, relax the geometry, untangle the polygons after we bend, and. Yeah, that's going to give us a better starting point. And when we have a nice clean situation like this, we can add some more polygons there, add some more edge loops, and not be, you know, completely lost in it. And so that's what I'm doing right now. After I cleaned up that situation there, I'm going to add a bit more polygons there again to do the same thing we did on the left shoulder, and that is to add a little bit of creasing to the clothes. And again, we see here, you know, a little bit of a tangled up situation, but it's a quick fix, so we can move on. So just get in there and you know, zoom in as close as you need to have a full understanding of what's happening with the geometry. And I'll basically, you know, just doing the same thing we did on the left side, adding those creases. And I'm kind of also going away from it, from, you know, from this area, just to see how much is it visible from a distance, approximately where, you know, you just want to put it in approximate distance from where you're thinking your camera is going to be looking, just to see what's happening from that distance, and kind of bending it a little bit more there. And yeah, it's looking pretty good. Has a few more adjustments, a few more tweaks here and there. And doing the same thing for the rest of the arm. Yeah, it's, you know, there's no fastener rule here, you know, just kind of jitter it around. But you should always be mindful of the arm, you know, of the underlying topology that's supposed to be underneath these clothes. So you should always try to maintain the structure and integrity of the arm that's supposed to be underneath those sleeves. So when you're jittering it, you should have that, you know, in your mind. Kind of jitter it more on the bottom side than on the upper side. I just want to add a bit more detail here. And yeah. Looking pretty good. Okay. That's a little bit more adjustment to it. And I just toggle from polygon to sub-patch mode to see, you know, how much those creases are going to come out. And add, you know, add some edge loops if you feel, you know, some areas should be a little bit more bulging. And yeah, I'm increasing all of these jitters, you know, just moving points a little bit more, you know, so that they're more noticeable in the grand picture. Okay, so nice spot to end this session. And in the next session, we are going to start to work on the fingers.